thing blacked out with just our W logos. That's what we want to do.
Coating the whole thing falls right into our whole new theme of Body Armor by Linex.
We usually use it for customers. We'll drop cars off, but we'll use it for SEMA and big events that we go to because it sets up where we can sell stuff out of the side of it. So it's really like our marketing vehicle.
So what needs to be done here?
Kenny?
Well, we'll totally disassemble for you guys, but we want different pieces of it, all matted black and everything. So we'll take apart what we want to paint, and we'll basically give you pieces that we can actually Linex. The side, that's all yours.
The trailer, the cab, like everything.
Well, now here's the big question. When do you need it back?
Well, see, this is cool because now I'm on the opposite side of this. If we can get this thing done in a couple weeks, it would be awesome. We'll strip it down. We'll bring it to you guys. You guys do your magic to it. We'll bring it back. We'll put it together. The rest will be history.
Well, this will be an amazing thing to have on display for both of us. And you know what? We have a project for you guys, too, as well, that I think falls right in line with what we're doing here.
There's always a catch, huh, kid? All right, you want to go in the conference room?
Let's talk about it.
All right, let's do it. All right, so we challenge you guys. You guys now challenge us.
Well, Ryan, you know, we're starting to put out there the Body Armor by Linex because it's become so popular. You know, some of that is because of the show that you do has brought so much attention to coating the whole vehicles. So we want to do a project vehicle just for Linex, and we want you guys to do it. We want to coat the whole vehicle.
Okay.
What do you think about that?
Here's, I guess, the biggest challenge is everything, you know, everybody knows is truck bed liner. You know what I mean? So I think we should really hit them over the top of the head with doing something different, like a car. So people can see it being used in a different way than the traditional bed liner.
Well, that's perfect for us. What kind of car would you have in mind? What do you think?
We got something that attracts to everybody. I mean, what's one of the hottest cars out right now?
Yeah, I mean, the Camaro would be cool. We could do two different colors. We could do like one color and then do the stripe in another color. I mean, people aren't gonna expect that from you guys.
No.
You know, and I think if that's the way you wanna push it, that's the perfect way.
We're known best for the truck bed liner, and so putting it on a vehicle, on a car, rather than a truck bed, is a new challenge for us.
Taking a vehicle like that, that's never been coated before with a coating, putting the body armor on it, and then just taking all aspects of the vehicle to the next level, it should be a showstopper.
It'll be a muscle car, and it'll move, but it'll perform like it's supposed to perform, and then I'll have Ish do some magic on the interior, put a sound system in it, and almost like a typical Camaro that we would build, only cooler by putting the coating on the outside and inside.
We're going to make this Camaro beautiful. We're going to make everybody want to buy a Camaro that has Linex on it with that kind of protection and that kind of performance. I think that doing something other than a pickup truck takes us outside the box a little bit, doing a little different. To be quite honest with you, I wouldn't mind expanding our retail market a little bit for customers who would want to get their own vehicles done. I can't wait to see the drawings and see what this is going to look like. Thank you, man.
Yeah, no, thank you.
I'm really excited.
Yeah, this is going to be good. It's going to be
beautiful.
Good.
It's going to
be beautiful.
Good.
Thank you.
And now Jeff's got work to do.
Yeah, Jeff, get back. You're going to have to get a whole lot of Linex ready. So I met with Linex. We had a good meeting. I'm going to go meet with Jeff, go over my ideas, put it on a rendering, shoot it over them. Hopefully they love it and we can start building it. So we got Linex, one of our good partners.
Yeah, the coats things for us.
Yeah, so it's like Linex is known for bed liners, right? Everybody that knows Linex, it's like, yeah, you spray in the inside of your bed. So I talked him into doing a Camaro, but the exterior, I want to Linex the whole thing and add color to it.
Okay. Oh, a colored Linex?
Yeah. So now I need you to take that idea and put it on this, and then I can take it to them and say, look. And they can say, cool, build it.
Okay. Are we going to do a lot to the interior, too?
I think an interior view would be cool, just so they can comprehend, like, doing the interior pieces. So we would two-tone the wheels paint usually, but let's two-tone the Linex the wheels. Now let's two-tone the interior. So all that kind of stuff I want to add into the car. You think you can get that done in a couple hours so I can get them to approve it and we can start building it?
It's actually done already.
Really?
I can do Camaros really easy. I've done 1,000 of them. But this one's a little bit different, so it should look pretty cool.
Coming up on West Coast Customs.
You got this Camaro?
Yes, sir.
Let's check it out. All right.
Wait till you see what we're going to do to this one.
So the rendering's done. It's been approved. The next step is to find a car. So I called up the local dealership that we always deal with, Connell Chevrolet, and said we need a black Camaro. They have one on the lot. They said come grab it. So I'm going to go with Hunter, jump in the tow truck, and pick up the Camaro. How you doing, man?
Great. How's it going?
Good to see you.
Likewise.
So, you got this Camaro?
Yes, sir.
Let's check it out. All right.
So 1SS, black on black. Wait till you see what we're going to do to this one.
Really?
Yeah. Full Line X. We're going to Line X the whole exterior, kind of like our tow truck. But we're going to do the racing stripe in it in blue.
Very cool.
Be kind of cool, something different. You want to pull it out so we can load it up?
Absolutely.
All right, let's do it. All right, Hunter. Let's load this bad boy up. Game time.
Ryan called me, asked for a black-on-black Camaro 1SS with a MyLink system in it. West Coast Customs does awesome work, and I can't wait to see what they're going to do with this vehicle. Really looking forward to it.
Next stop, West Coast Customs. All right, Hunter. Thank you for the ride. Now get back to work.
All right, bye.
Kenny!
Yes, dear.
We brought you a gift. Here's a key. It's a Camaro for our friends at Line X. But since we've done so many Camaros, it should be pretty easy.
Right? Nothing's easy.
Nothing's easy. But the good news is we don't have to paint it because they're going to Line X the whole thing. So they'll come in here. I figure that's why we start in here.
Okay.
So they can set up in here and do their Line X-ing. We can do the interior and then head to toe Line X. Interior pieces, wheels. But this will be unique. I mean, since we've been Line X-ing everything from
big rig
our big rig down to our Jeeps van to Jeeps to whatever, we might as well do this for them.
I know.
So, Skid, SLP on the phone. Get everything they got for this thing. I say we leave it in here, the whole build.
Yeah, we'll tear it down right in here.
Yeah, tear it down in here, let Line X come in, do what they need to do, and then you can get Ish on the interior and, you know, get Alex building the stereo system.
I think we strip it, get on a lift too, and get everything inside of it too. Body braces, everything, and then get back in here for the Line X.
Okay, yeah, however you want to do it. The plan's the plan. In your hands, buddy.
Like always.
Yeah, knock it out. All right, I'll get on the phone with SLP.
All righty.
I just went over the build with Kenny. He's going to get a team in here right now. They're going to break it down. Tomorrow we're going to put it over to Lyft. Hopefully SLP will have us all of our stuff by tomorrow. We're going to Line X a lot of these interior pieces to really give it a blue accent. The cool thing about this is we're going to show Line X being used in different ways than what people know Line X as.
It's a whole different process than just painting a car. We're actually going to have a really efficient texture to it. Two-tone it, change the whole interior up, kind of give it something different that we've always done at West Coast. We got SLP involved, we put supercharger, brakes, suspension, body braces, suspension coils and everything. Basically, package everything under this car, so we got the speed with the texture. First thing you do, grab my guys and get it torn down.
To showcase the new Line X body armor, it's time to put away the bed liners and bring in some muscle. GM will provide us with a 2013 Camaro, the perfect platform to put Line X to the test. The first thing to do is to tear this car down. We're going to remove the old exhaust, put on a new SLP exhaust, headers, and suspension. A new body kit will complete the design. Next, it's time to Line X the car from head to toe. We'll base the entire car in black and then lay out some blue stripes for a bold new look. Moving inside, blue Line X doors will echo the blue accents on the dash. And seats in black leather and suede with blue diamond stitching. An SLP supercharger will add a burst of horsepower to make this a true muscle car. And every car needs a great sound system. So we're gonna beef up the factory stereo using MB Quartz amps and subs, sitting in a custom Line X enclosure. And to finish it off, Continental tires will ride on Line X Asante wheels and Oracle headlights will light the way. It's time to move beyond truck beds and bring Line X into the future. Next on West Coast Customs.
Before Line X can come here and shoot this Camaro, they have to get another job done. This is probably the biggest job that they've ever done in their history, so I gotta make sure they get that finished first and then come over here and get the Camaro done. So we're building a car for Line X, a brand new Camaro. We're gonna Line X the exterior of this car black with some blue racing stripes. But before we get it into the booth to actually put the Line X on it, I called up our friends at SLP to send us some cool product. They have suspension, they have brakes, they have a cool hood for it, a nice front end, and of course a supercharger. So I wanna get all that stuff here, get it installed, and then get this thing Line X. Christmas came a little early here at West Coast Customs. Our friends from SLP totally hooked us up for this Camaro build. I'm excited to get this stuff all opened up and get it on the car.
SLP always delivers some of the best products. They got a whole new front end that they developed for us, so we're going to put a whole new front on this car. A new intake hood, basically a raised center section of the hood, give it a more performance look. We got springs, got a supercharger, everything we need for this car. So next thing is get them on the car.
All right, Kenny, good luck.
I need it. So what we're going to do is get the suspension on, get all these springs put in, the exhaust, and check the brakes out, and set up for the supercharger, and then we're going to fit the front bumper and the hood, and get this back to line X.
Okay.
Ready?
I'm gonna start the Linux Camaro. I got some equipment right here, some 12s, MB Core amplifiers, 6x9s, some monster wiring. My design is gonna be kind of plain and simple. It's more gonna be more of the sound that's gonna be coming into place in this one. And then we're gonna do a Linux cover for the subwoofer enclosure. I'm gonna make two individual boxes. I have to do that because the opening in the trunk is so small, so I can't do one box with two 12s. I'm gonna go ahead and do two individual 12 boxes. A lot of people say it looks plain and simple, but sometimes plain and simple is harder to do. If you want a lot of bass, you want to do a lot for a bandpass box. If you want sound quality, you want to do like a seal enclosure. But what happens here in this slot port box, when the subwoofer gets the power from the amplifier, it creates a sound wave when it goes up and down. The sound wave bounces off the box, travels through the port, and then it starts coming out. But before that sound wave comes out, there's gonna be other sound waves getting created by the subwoofer. So by the time the first sound wave comes out, there's gonna be like two or three sound waves right behind it. And that's where you're gonna get most of the pressure out of the music. That's why these boxes are pretty loud.
Before Linex can come here and shoot this Camaro, they have to get another job done, which is our big rig. This is probably the biggest job that they've ever done in their history. So I gotta make sure they get that finished first and then come over here and get the Camaro done.
Well, now that we got the truck here on site, we're all set, we're ready to go. We're gonna start masking this thing off. It's the first thing we have to do. Right after that, we're gonna sand all the paint so we can get a nice good etch so we can get the coating to stick. And then after that, we're gonna spray our product on there and give it back over to West Coast. Here all night last night, getting the truck prepped and ready to go. We got some panels in the booth, and we're gonna let Justin get to spraying on those.
Big rig's back, it looks amazing. Now I gotta grab the guys, have them paint all the trim. I'm gonna sit with Kevin, get him to water jet all the logos out, and then this thing will be ready for the road.
Scott.
Yeah.
Big rig's here.
This is a lot of material.
The doors.
chrome, gloss black.
I was thinking the W on the back door.
But we still have the cab also.
We need to brand all of it.
So we got to pick the brands that we were going to put up here. So timeline, baseball, sponsors, W.
Cool.
All right.
Coming up on West Coast Customs.
Originally, when we talked about doing this build, we said, hey, we're going to Line-X the whole thing and do a blue Line-X stripe down the center, but never really thought how we're going to break it apart. Really, at the end of the day, he's got his work cut out for him. Now that SLP's parts are on this car, suspension, brakes, headers and exhaust system. The next step is move it over to the body shop, get it masked up so Line-X can come in and do their magic. To body armor an entire car, we're gonna start by tearing it down. Step one, prep. We'll prep the car like we would for a paint job. We'll sand the body indoors to give the car a rough surface so the Line-X can stick. Step two, we'll spray the entire car in black Line-X body armor, holding the spray gun close to get the smooth surface, and far away to get the pebbled surface. Step three, stripes. To Line-X the blue stripes, we're gonna lay out the pattern and tape. Spray it blue, and then carefully razor blade the tape off to create the perfect lines. And then you will have a Camaro with body armor built to last.
So we just got done installing all the suspension, the exhaust and the headers. Now we rolled in the spray booth. We're gonna start A-grit sandpaper the whole car, kind of give it that really extra bite when Line-X attaches to it. Once we're done, we get a Line-X crew in here, get a Line-X. Good. Thanks for coming down. You ready for this project?
I am, definitely. Right. I brought some samples for us to take a look at.
So Kenny's got it in the booth. It's ready for you.
Awesome.
He already had the guys prep it.
I guess
the biggest thing is let's talk about these stripes and stuff, huh? Yeah.
So that's the blue texture that we're looking at.
Okay.
What I brought here is blue texture, blue smooth, black smooth. Is this true at mid-60s SS style with the pinstripe on the outside, or are we doing the just the block stripes kind of like they are today?
No, we're doing the pinstripe.
Okay. Well, to define the stripe on here, we need to have a high gloss outline. Right. Kind of set it off like a pinstripe.
Yeah.
And so let's lay this out here and take a look at it.
So
here's the base black, right? There's what it looks like with the blue stripe.
Yeah, that's going to look good.
So then if we do this out here like this, we want to do a high gloss black stripe.
Yeah, definitely black.
Seems like it pops a little more.
Yeah. I mean, and it feels more like a pinstripe when you see that, too.
Right. Whatever you want, I can do it.
But what's the idea? Are we going to go ahead and texture the whole car, do what we got to do, and then put the car back together and tape it all together?
As long as I use your guys' help with the measurements and make sure we got the stripes where they need to be, we can do it in pieces.
We'll have to put it somewhere together just so we can actually line up
the stripes.
Yeah. Right. All right, cool. Let's get it done.
Thanks, guys.
Let's get her done.
Originally, when we talked about doing this build, we said, hey, we're going to Line-X the whole thing and do a blue Line-X stripe down the center, but never really thought how we're going to break it apart. So Jeff had a couple good ideas. I think once we set them together, you could definitely tell it popped a lot more with the gloss black, so we're going to go with that. We talked about how we're going to lay out the stripes and where they're going to go. And really, at the end of the day, he's got his work cut out for him.
Fortunately, when we got here this morning, the car is all masked up, ready for us to go, which is great. The only thing I have to do is put down some special tape around the edges where it counts. Now, what we're going to do is wipe the car and start shooting product. We're going to use our Graco spray machine to spray out the Line-X body armor. This is our micro-mobile machine we use to do small portable jobs. On average, for like a truck bed liner, which we're best known for, it takes only 15-20 minutes to spray a truck, sometimes less. But all the work is in the prep. First thing we're going to do is we're going to paint all the door jams, and we're going to do the rest of the body panels. So we'll be done. We'll have the whole car black in a matter of minutes. right now in the process, we are ready to lay down our blue stripes. We have painstakingly taken our time to put down a nice high gloss finish on the trunk, the hood, and the front fascia of the car. And now we're going to put down our West Coast Customs Phantom Blue. So really to set this car off.
Saffron.
Hey. What's up?
So I've done some homework. Looks like traditional SS stripes don't want the roof. I like that one, and I like this back. A lot of them go over the whole entire back, but I think it's like just too many things going on. But basically, right. I'm thinking not to do the roof. So no. What I want to do is kind of just bring the stripes into here, finish them off like the hood, and then take the traditional SS front hood and integrate it.
And we're going to continue with the traditional pinstripe around the edge too. Is that right?
Correct.
So we're going to twist it up a little bit. We're actually going to use a solvented paint and the West Coast Customs Phantom Blue for our stripes as a base coat, and then we're going to put our texture on the top of that and be done with it.
Customs.
I got an interesting call today.
Kenny, let's talk carts.
Go-karts.
Go-karts.
Now that LineX is underway, everything's running smoothly on that. I got an interesting call today from our partners at Prax Air saying they want us to customize a buggy that they want to auction off at the FabTech show in Las Vegas for Wounded Warriors, which honestly is a big thing for us. Plus Prax Air is a great partner. Sounds like fun. I'm going to grab Kenny, sit down, and go over how we're going to build this.
Kenny, let's talk carts.
You ready to talk cart?
Go-karts.
Go-karts.
So, it's not 100% of the way we're going to build it, but I think this is like a good start. It's a little bit different than the normal build. As you know, it's not a car, it's a cart. It's for a great cause. They're going to auction it off to raise money, and it's on Veterans Day weekend, which is cool, you know, so it's got that American feel. We're going to have Ishmael, you know, add a little bit of West Coast Customs flavor, and then let Kenny put some cool shape to it, and then it'll be off to Vegas.
Ryan designed an external body for this build. So what we got to do is basically build a whole entire exterior part out of aluminum. When it comes to building parts of aluminum, the number one thing is making a really, really good template. If your template is perfect, your aluminum is probably going to be that much better. You know, the main thing you need is cardboard, some magnets, pencil, and everywhere to really make a really good template. So let's get started. So one of the hardest things to do is get all the curves exactly where you want them. So what you do, when you make a piece of cardboard, you really transfer all your characteristic lines on that piece of cardboard and make your cardboard exactly the way you want the aluminum made. If you can make the cardboard exactly the way you want it, when you actually make the aluminum, it's going to come out exactly like it. Sometimes the cardboard doesn't bend exactly. Metal doesn't bend. So if you have to bend the cardboard, that means you need a stretcher, a shrinker, or something to actually take the material and gather it or expand it, depending on what you're going to use.
Better than the rendering. That's good.
And the person that's bidding on it's going to appreciate the aluminum work and stuff like that, so they'll see the creativity in it. You know, usually when we do a rendering, it's a rendering of a car. We kind of know what we're going to do with it. Once we got it into the fab shop, you know, Kenny did his magic. He started doing a lot of aluminum work on it, which is good because at the end of the day, we want to raise money for a great cause. I think the work and the craftsmanship of what we're doing to this thing is definitely going to take it up a couple notches.
The next thing you do is we want the roof to be a little bit stronger, a little more rigid, so what we're going to do is we're going to add a B-roll or a step roll to the part to give it a little bit of detail, but also more strength. And that's how you do a B-roll.
So we're 2 days away from having to ship this off to Vegas to the Prax Air Show. The body panels look amazing. I'm looking at everything. I mean, the craftsmanship that's in this, we definitely cannot wrap it. We gotta paint it. The good news is Rhino's here working on another project. Rhino! So I know you're busy.
Hey, what's up, man?
I know you're busy in here, but I wanted to see if you wanted to take over this real quick for me.
Oh, take over things real quick?
Yeah. Because Kenny went way overboard with building these body panels.
Kenny, no. That's very crazy talk.
But it's good. It's actually a good thing he went overboard.
All right.
But now I need you to go overboard.
Let's go check it out.
Let's go check it. Check it. That's the roof piece.
Okay.
These are the sides, and then they're doing the front end right now.
So the front will be blue with stars, and then we'll do red and white down the side, maybe do a strip down here to make the blue go to the sides.
Okay.
And then flip a couple off the top.
Yeah, do what you do best, Rhino.
All right, cool. So Ryan pulled me from one job, throws me on this thing. We're going to do the buggy with the American flag. It's got white stars, blue field in the front, red and white stripes down the side, airbrush it like it's flowing on the wind, slap it on, they'll give this thing away.
So let's set a time frame on this. Since this has to be loaded tomorrow morning.
What else is new?
That's awesome. How much time do you need?
Realistically, probably 2 hours, 2.5.
If you make 2 hours, I'll give you $100. If you don't make 2 hours, you owe me $100.
Oh, yay. Thanks, man. It's a bet.
Good?
All right.
All right, it's a bet.
Set go. Now? All right, I'll see you in 2 hours.
No pressure. He had 9 minutes left, so I guess I owe him some money. The good news is, now we can start assembling it and get it off to Vegas.
Now it's time to collect that $100.
Next on West Coast Customs.
I have to get to Vegas to see who won the bid on this.
As usual, Ryan just threw me another build on top of the other 10 builds that I'm working on.
We're going to go out the box on this one.
But this one is going to be unique.
So we have a lot going on in the shop right now. The big rig's back to get assembled. The Camaro's been line X. We gotta start assembling that, get the supercharger put on it. And I have to get to Vegas to see who won the bid on this, because this is a really big deal for us. Show in the Prax Air booth, the actual Prax Air boxing ring, for me to sign some autographs for some of the fans and actually give away this go-kart today. It was a fun build for us because it was something different, and to do a go-kart that we're going to auction off for Wounded Warriors. I mean, it's a great thing. How you doing, man?
What's up, Ryan?
How are you?
Good, man. What's happening?
The booth is great.
Thanks, man. Thanks for
coming. I like my boxing ring.
Do you?
Yeah. It's cool.
Great.
It's cool.
Well, I got to tell you, man, we have a winner.
Cool.
So what I like to do is have you present Steve Fife the keys to his new go-kart. And Steve's going to handle it, man. Obviously, all the proceeds are going to be going to the Wounded Warrior Project and support our veterans.
This was a fun build, you know, something different for us, and I think the guys put in a lot of effort to really make it cool so we could raise money for a great cause.
I'm thrilled. My brother-in-law is involved in the Tampa Outpost of Wounded Warriors. His two sons are in the Marines, my other nephew, and I have one in the Coast Guard and a lot of vets. We're going to let them use it every one of their exhibits and shows that they do where they're pulling people together, volunteers, to help the vets. And we're going to have that sitting there.
That'll be cool. That'll be a cool
It's going to be cool,
to it, yeah.
And the vets feel good about it, and we thank you.
Cool.
I hadn't seen the cart at all until it pulled up on Thursday night. We were pretty blown away. All the guys that were working the show, all the Teamsters, all the riggers, they all stopped and came out. I think the message is great, and I think the real use of the go-kart is even better.
They're used to building bigger things, and this is custom down. I mean, it's really a wonderful concept, and it's perfect for my family to present something back to the vets.
today was a good day. Steve won the bid on this car. I think Steve's a great person to win it. I'm going to sign some autographs and finish this day out. And now I gotta get back on the Camaro. The line X turned out amazing, but now we gotta make sure the interior turns out just as amazing. So I'm gonna sit down with Ash, come up with a plan, and get this interior started.
All right, Ash, I got another one for you.
Another one? What do you have for me? A race?
It's not a race this time.
Okay, but you got a Camaro. We're gonna go out the box on this one. You know, recently we line X a tow truck, the van, the Jeep, you know. We're gonna line X a Camaro, but we're not gonna just do it black. We're gonna do it black with blue racing stripes. I think it'll be totally sick. You know, I just rendered this out to kind of give you a quick little idea. But I want the interior to be you. I think blue stitching, black suede, black leather, and you know, you just kind of do what you do best. Make them hate us. Make them hate us. I like it when they hate us.
These diamonds, they kind of play it out, man. So I will come up with something, still diamonds, but I will come up with something clean. I mean, think about it.
This build's gonna be a little different, you know. I gave Ish a quick little rendering to kind of show him the idea. I think he gets the concept. Black Line X on the exterior, blue Line X stripes, do some black leather, do some black suede, blue stitching, bada bing, bada boom. Boom.
As usual, Ryan just threw me another build on top of the other 10 builds that I'm working on, but this one is gonna be unique. Ryan wanted me to be creative. I want to do diamonds, but I'm going to reinvent the diamonds. Pretty simple, but I think that the car is going to have a big impact. Adrian.
Yeah?
This is what I want to do, homie. Steel diamonds, but I don't want to do diamonds all the way. I want to end up with double stitch.
Looks different.
This is going to be single stitch, but the stitch is going to come through here. Believe me this, my friend. It's gonna look very nice.
Ryan gonna like it?
You only have one choice. Like it or like it.
All right.
We actually have to raise weight every single line by hand and then slowly peel the paper. Now since I get the paper off, the next thing to do is kind of recreate the lines I actually taped on there. I'm gonna lay all my tape back out and actually raise the weight between each and every one.
Coming up on West Coast Customs.
In the shop, there's always guys, and we're always doing what we do. So to bring a girl in and show these guys how to do it, it's going to be interesting.
The superchargers take 9 to 12 hours to install.
This one, I'm going to have done in about 4 hours.
We've already installed the SLP headers and exhaust system, but to really give this car some boost, we're going to add a supercharger. So the SLP guys are going to send their techs out to install one.
What's up, Dave?
Hey, Ryan, how you doing?
Good, sir.
Good to see you.
Thank you for coming out.
Oh, thank you.
Hi.
Ryan, this is Jessica.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
This is Brian.
Hey, Brian.
How are you doing, man?
Nice to meet you.
Jessica's going to be doing the install today.
Oh, cool. It's nice to have a girl in the shop.
Absolutely.
Be good. Do you need anything else from us?
No, I think we've got tools, coffee. I think we're good to go.
Tools and coffee will be good to go, huh?
That's all we need.
All right. When do you think you'll be done with it?
Should take about 3.5-4 hours.
Wow.
Today we're going to be installing a brand new SLP supercharger. This is the first of an SLP line of superchargers, and this happens to be our very first production piece that we're installing on a Camaro. Typically, superchargers take anywhere from 9 to 12 hours to install.
The great thing about this supercharger is it's been completely redesigned. This one I'm going to have done in about 4 hours or so. It is also going to add 160 rear wheel horsepower to the car versus the older generation only adding 120. It's going to be really fast.
So I just met with David and his team from SLP. He brought Jessica with him, an installer, which is cool, you know. In the shop, there's always guys, and we're always doing what we do. So to bring a girl and show these guys how to do it, it's going to be interesting. She said she'll be done in 4 hours. Hopefully she gets it done a little bit sooner. We can go do some donuts.
And now we're ready to install the supercharger. This is the component that forces the air into the engine, and more air equals more horsepower.
Tuned, ready to go, just waiting on the engine covers, and then you can drive it.
I'm excited. That was fast. That's awesome. They're going to be stoked, too, when they see this. I mean, they've seen the rendering, but when they see this car, like, 100% done in their SEMA booth, they're going to be blown away. First thing in the morning, I'll take it out, test drive it, maybe do a couple donuts, and then ship it off to the customer.
Sounds good.
All right, thanks, man. Always thank you. It's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Got about 600 horsepower, lots of torque, lots of power, great fuel economy. I think Ryan's really going to enjoy this.
Next on West Coast Customs.
So the Camaro's done, so I'm going to go test drive it, make sure everything's cool, and then we'll get it off the line. I invited Linex over to do a build for us. I wanted to Linex our big rig. It turned into them wanting us to do a build for them. We found a local dealership that had a black-on-black Camaro. We brought it in. We called up our friends from SLP. They brought in all their top-of-line product for it, from brakes to headers to suspension. And then the next step was to get Linex. So they came in, Linexed the whole car black. Then we did some blue racing stripes on it. We also did the wheels, the speaker box, and some interior pieces. Then it was time for Ish to do his magic on the seats and the door panels. Then it was time to get supercharged. Now we're in the final assembly stage. After that, we have to get this car on the road and get it off the Linex for the big reveal.
Now it's time to hear this beast. That smell for is perfect.
Now the Camaro, it looks amazing. I mean, this body armor, I think, is going to be something totally different for them as a brand. And to see color on top of their black traditional Linex, I think it's going to blow people away. So the Camaro's done, turned out amazing. I think, you know, the SLP performance that they added to it makes a huge difference. So I'm gonna go test drive it, make sure everything's cool, and then we'll get it off the Linex. Just got here, it's about to pull up. I'm gonna go inside, get their team, bring them out here. We're gonna look at the big rig. I'm gonna open the door, and then I'm gonna pull out their surprise.
Hey Ryan, what's going on?
Good to see you.
Looks good. Let me introduce you to Kevin.
Nice to meet you, Ryan.
So you ready?
But let's take a look.
You gotta see this.
Man, I can't wait to see this.
Turned out amazing.
Oh, wow. That looks great. That's a lot of product. That's a big truck.
I really like the blacked out look. I think it gives it like a stealth look.
Is that cut out?
It's on top of it.
It's on top of
it?
Yeah.
I'll go get the team.
You get your team. And the other thing is I brought your surprise.
What surprise?
When you see what we created, and this car is really going to open the doors to a big future, I think.
Hey,
first little glimpse. Team WCC, because I wanted to build this like we would build a custom car, but use your product on everything. So we built the speaker box in the back all custom, but we Linexed it. We
did all the interior pieces.
Yeah, we did it all. So it's all in the interior also. So this, all these panels.
That's Linex inside?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I'm excited about the exterior and just the look. You wouldn't think that a car would look as good as it does, as you see here with the Camaro. I'm tickled pink.
That's what I do when I work with a lot of these brands. It's like coming up with something different, come up with the cool factor. And I think we really did it on this.
It's not too much.
It's not too much, but people can see this now and relate and say, wow, I can do that to my car.
I think you hit a home run on it.
Yeah.
The way this build came about is we created this product for the exterior of vehicles. Not as aggressive as our normal bedliner material, but a smooth satin finish. We are trying to figure out how we could get that to the general public and how we could make that a new product for Linex.
Oh yeah, look at that. So we built our speaker box, but we put your product on it.
And the other thing is now you don't have to park your hot rod way out in the back of the parking lot.
Right.
Don't worry about shopping cart dings or door dings, right?
Park it right up front.
Challenge was this. When we came here, Brian said, we have a project for you. And we said, okay, what do you got? He says, how about a 60-foot big rig? This is hours and hours of labor put into this thing, and it looks great.
I'm excited, and I think they're really excited. And for the future of us working together, I think this is going to be a great, great business.
Next week on West Coast Customs.
So I got an interesting email today from a company called the Ohana Group. They actually build resorts, and they got a bunch of projects going on right now all over the world. One of the ones they're working on is in Cabo, Mexico.
What's up, boss?
Got a little surprise for you.
Boom.
Sick.
This is pretty much got it all. Now it's time to get back home.
One's going
to
serve drinks. One's going to serve food.
Start with a touch-up gun and basically work our way from light to dark.
Oh, my God.
Nuts. And then ship it off to the customer.
Sounds good.
All right, thanks, man. Always thank you. It's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Got about 600 horsepower, lots of torque, lots of power, great fuel economy. I think Ryan's really going to enjoy this.
Next on West Coast Customs.
So the Camaro's done, so I'm going to go test drive it, make sure everything's cool, and then we'll get it off the line. I invited Linex over to do a build for us. I wanted to Linex our big rig. It turned into them wanting us to do a build for them. We found a local dealership that had a black-on-black Camaro. We brought it in. We called up our friends from SLP. They brought in all their top-of-line product for it, from brakes to headers to suspension. And then the next step was to get Linex. So they came in, Linexed the whole car black. Then we did some blue racing stripes on it. We also did the wheels, the speaker box, and some interior pieces. Then it was time for Ish to do his magic on the seats and the door panels. Then it was time to get supercharged. Now we're in the final assembly stage. After that, we have to get this car on the road and get it off the Linex for the big reveal.
Now it's time to hear this beast. That smell of four is perfect.
Now the Camaro, it looks amazing. I mean, this body armor, I think, is going to be something totally different for them as a brand. And to see color on top of their black traditional line X, I think it's going to blow people away. So the Camaro's done, it turned out amazing. I think, you know, the SLP performance that they added to it makes a huge difference. So I'm gonna go test drive it, make sure everything's cool, and then we'll get it off the line X. Performance. It's smooth surface and far away to get to pebbled surface. Step three, stripes. To line X the blue stripes, we're going to lay out the pattern in tape. Spray it blue and then carefully razor blade the tape off to create the perfect lines. And then you will have a Camaro with body armor built to last.
So we just got done installing all the suspension, the exhaust and the headers. Now we rolled in the spray booth. We're going to start A-grit sandpaper the whole car. Kind of give it that really extra bite when Line X attaches to it. Once we're done, we get Line X crew in here, get a Line X. Good. Thanks for coming down. You ready for this project?
I am, definitely. Right. I brought some samples for us to take a look at.
So Kenny's got it in the booth. It's ready for you.
Awesome.
He already had the guys prep it.
I guess
the biggest thing is let's talk about these stripes and stuff, huh? Yeah.
So that's the blue texture that we're looking at.
Okay.
What I brought here is blue texture, blue smooth, black smooth. Is this true at mid-60s SS style with the pinstripe on the outside, or are we doing the just block stripes kind of like they are today?
No, we're doing the pinstripe.
Okay. Well, to define the stripe on here, we need to have a high-gloss outline.
Right.
Kind of set off like a pinstripe.
Yeah, yeah.
And so let's lay this out here and take a look at it.
So
here's the base black, right? There's what it looks like with the blue stripe.
Yeah, that's going to look good.
So then if we do this out here like this, we want to do a high-gloss black stripe.
Yeah, definitely black.
It seems like it pops a little more.
Yeah. I mean, and it feels more like a pinstripe when you see that, too.
Right. Whatever you want, I can do it.
But what's the idea? Are we going to go ahead and texture the whole car, do we got to do it, and put the car back together and tape it all together?
As long as I use your guys' help with the measurements and make sure we got the stripes where they need to be, we can do it in pieces.
We'll have to put somewhere together just so we can actually
line up the stripes.
Yeah. Right. All right, cool. Let's get it done.
Thanks, guys.
Let's get her done.
Originally, when we talked about doing this build, we said, hey, we're going to line X the whole thing and do a blue line X stripe down the center, but never really thought how we're going to break it apart. So Jeff had a couple good ideas. I think once we set them together, you could definitely tell it popped a lot more with the gloss black, so we're going to go with that. We talked about how we're going to lay out the stripes and where they're going to go. And really, at the end of the day, he's got his work cut out for him.
Fortunately, when we got here this morning, the car is all masked up, ready for us to go, which is great. The only thing I have to do is put down...
Touch-up.
Yeah, you
Sweet.
Got time. He got touch-up time. Nice.
He had 9 minutes left, so I guess I owe him some money. The good news is, now we can start assembling it and get it off to Vegas.
Now it's time to collect that $100.
Next on West Coast Customs.
I have to get to Vegas to see who won the bid on this.
As usual, Ryan, just from another bill on top of the other 10 bills that I'm working on.
We're going to go out the box on this one.
But this one is going to be unique.
Boom. So we have a lot going on in the shop right now. The big rig's back to get assembled. The Camaro's been line X. We gotta start assembling that, get the supercharger put on it. And I have to get to Vegas to see who won the bid on this, because this is a really big deal for us.
Show in the Praxair booth, the actual Praxair boxing ring, for me to sign some autographs for some of the fans and actually give away this go-kart today. It was a fun build for us because it was something different, and to do a go-kart that we're going to auction off for Wounded Warriors. I mean, it's a great thing. How you doing, man?
What's up, Ryan?
How are you?
How you doing, man? What's happening?
The booth is great.
Thanks, man. Thanks for
coming. I like my boxing ring.
Do you?
Yeah.
It's cool. Great.
It's cool.
Well, I got to tell you, man, we have a winner.
Cool.
So what I like to do is have you present Steve Fife the keys to his new go-kart. And Steve's going to handle it, man. Obviously, all the proceeds are going to be going to the Wounded Warrior Project and support our veterans.
This was a fun build. You know, something different for us. And I think the guys put in a lot of effort to really make it cool so we can raise money for a great cause.
I'm thrilled. My brother-in-law is involved in the Tampa Outpost of Wounded Warriors. His two sons are in the Marines, my other nephew, and I have one in the Coast Guard and a lot of vets. We're going to let them use it every one of their exhibits and shows that they do where they're pulling people together, volunteers, to help the vets. And we're going to have that sitting
there.
That'll
be cool. That'll be a cool
It's going to be cool,
yeah.
And the vets feel good about it, and we thank you.
Cool.
I hadn't seen the cart at all until it pulled up on Thursday night. We were pretty blown away. All the guys that were working the show, all the Teamsters, all the riggers, they all stopped and came out. I think the message is great, and I think the real use of
supercharger, brakes, suspension, body braces, suspension coils and everything, basically package everything under this car, so we got the speed with the texture. First thing you do, grab my guys and get it torn down.
To showcase the new Line X body armor, it's time to put away the bed liners and bring in some muscle. GM will provide us with a 2013 Camaro, the perfect platform to put Line X to the test. The first thing to do is to tear this car down. We're going to remove the old exhaust, put on a new SLP exhaust, headers, and suspension. A new body kit will complete the design. Next, it's time to Line X the car from head to toe. We'll base the entire car in black and then lay out some blue stripes for a bold new look. Moving inside, blue Line X doors will echo the blue accents on the dash. And seats in black leather and suede with blue diamond stitching. An SLP supercharger will add a burst of horsepower to make this a true muscle car. And every car needs a great sound system. So we're going to beef up the factory stereo using MB Quartz amps and subs, sitting in a custom Line X enclosure. And to finish it off, Continental tires will ride on Line X Asante wheels, and Oracle headlights will light the way. It's time to move beyond truck beds and bring Line X into the future. Next on West Coast Customs.
Before Line X can come here and shoot this Camaro, they have to get another job done. This is probably the biggest job that they've ever done in their history, so I gotta make sure they get that finished first and then come over here and get the Camaro done. So we're building a car for Line X, a brand new Camaro. We're gonna Line X the exterior of this car black with some blue racing stripes. But before we get it into the booth to actually put the Line X on it, I called up our friends at SLP to send us some cool product. They have suspension, they have brakes, they have a cool hood for it, a nice front end, and of course a supercharger. So I wanna get all that stuff here, get it installed, and then get this thing Line X.
Christmas came a little early here at West Coast Customs. Our friends from SLP totally hooked us up for this Camaro build. I'm excited to get this stuff all opened up and get it on the car.
That's
SLP always delivers some of the best products. They got a whole new front end that they developed for us, so we're going to put a whole new front on this car. A new intake hood, basically a raised center section of the hood, give it a more performance look. We got to spread the whole car, kind of give it that really extra bite when Linex attaches to it. Once we're done, we get Linex crew in here, get a Linex.
Good. Thanks for coming down. You ready for this project?
I am, definitely. Right. I brought some samples for us to take a look at.
So Kenny's got it in the booth. It's ready for you.
Awesome.
He already had the guys prep it.
I guess
the biggest thing is let's talk about these stripes and stuff, huh?
Yeah. So that's the blue texture that we're looking at.
Okay.
What I brought here is blue texture, blue smooth, black smooth. Is this true at mid-60s SS style with the pinstripe on the outside, or are we doing the just block stripes kind of like they are today?
No, we're doing the pinstripe.
Okay. Well, to define the stripe on here, we need to have a high-gloss outline. Right. Kind of set it off like a pinstripe.
Yeah, yeah.
And so let's lay this out here and take a look at it.
So
here's the base black, right? There's what it looks like with the blue stripe.
Yeah, that's going to look good.
So then if we do this out here like this, we want to do a high-gloss black stripe.
Yeah, definitely black.
Seems like it pops a little more.
Yeah. I mean, and it feels more like a pinstripe when you see that, too.
Right. Whatever you want, I can do it.
But what's the idea? Are we going to go ahead and texture the whole car, do we got to do it, and put the car back together and tape it all together?
As long as I use your guys' help with the measurements and make sure we got the stripes where they need to be, we can do it in pieces.
We'll have to put it somewhat together just so we can actually
line up the stripes.
Yeah.
Right. All right, cool. Let's get it done.
Thanks, guys.
Let's get her done. Originally, when we talked about doing this build, we said, hey, we're going to Linex the whole thing and do a blue Linex stripe down the center, but never really thought how we're going to break it apart. So Jeff had a couple good ideas. I think once we set them together, you could definitely tell it popped a lot more with the gloss black, so we're going to go with that. We talked about how we're going to lay out the stripes and where they're going to go. And really, at the end of the day, he's got his work cut out for him.
Fortunately, when we got here this morning, the car is all masked up, ready for us to go, which is great. The only thing I have to do is put down some special tape around the edges where it counts. Now, what we're going to do is wipe the car and start shooting product. We're going to use our Graco spray machine to spray out the Linex body armor. This is our micro mobile machine we use to do small portable jobs. On average, for like a truck bed liner, which we're best known for, it takes only 15, 20 minutes to spray a truck, sometimes less. But all the work is in the prep. First thing we're gonna do is we're gonna paint all the door jams.
A bandpass box, if you want sound quality, you wanna do like a seal enclosure. But what happens here in this slot port box, when the subwoofer gets the power from the amplifier, it creates a sound wave when it goes up and down. The sound wave bounces off the box, travels through the port, and then it starts coming out. But before that sound wave comes out, there's gonna be other sound waves getting created by the subwoofer. So by the time the first sound wave comes out, there's gonna be like two or three sound waves right behind it. And that's where you're gonna get most of the pressure out of the music. That's why these boxes are pretty loud.
Before Linex can come here and shoot this Camaro, they have to get another job done, which is our big rig. This is probably the biggest job that they've ever done in their history. So I gotta make sure they get that finished first and then come over here and get the Camaro done.
Well, now that we got the truck here on site, we're all set, we're ready to go. We're gonna start masking this thing off. It's the first thing we have to do. Right after that, we're gonna sand all the paint so we can get a nice good etch so we can get the coating to stick. And then after that, we're gonna spray our product on there and give it back over to West Coast. All night last night, get the truck prepped and ready to go. We got some panels in the booth, and we're gonna let Justin get to spraying on those.
Mm-hmm.
big rig's back. It looks amazing. Now I've got to grab the guys, have them paint all the trim. I'm going to sit with Kevin, get him to water jet all the logos out, and then this thing will be ready for the road.
Scott.
Yeah.
Big rig's here.
This is a lot of material.
The doors.
Yeah, that looks nice. So all the chrome, gloss black. I was thinking the W on the back door.
But we still have the cab also. We need a brand all of it.
So we gotta pick the brands that we were gonna put up here. So timeline, baseball, sponsors, W.
Cool.
Alright. Yeah, I mean, the Camaro would be cool. We could do two different colors. We could do like one color and then do the stripe in another color. I mean, people aren't gonna expect that from you guys.
No.
You know, and I think if that's the way you wanna push it, that's the perfect way.
We're known best for the truck bed liner, and so putting it on a vehicle, on a car, rather than a truck bed, is a new challenge for us.
Taking a vehicle like that, that's never been coated before with a coating, putting the body armor on it, and then just taking all aspects of the vehicle to the next level, it should be a showstopper.
It'll be a muscle car, and it'll move, but it'll perform like it's supposed to perform, and then I'll have Ish do some magic on the interior, put a sound system in it. And almost like a typical Camaro that we would build, only cooler by putting the coating on the outside and inside.
We're going to make this Camaro beautiful. We're going to make everybody want to buy a Camaro that has Linex on it with that kind of protection and that kind of performance. I think that doing something other than a pickup truck takes us outside the box a little bit, doing a little different. To be quite honest with you, I wouldn't mind expanding our retail market a little bit for customers who would want to get their own vehicles done. I can't wait to see the drawings and see what this is going to look like. Thank you, man.
Yeah, no, thank you.
I'm really excited.
Yeah, that's going to be good. It's going to be
beautiful.
Thank you.
And now Jeff's got work to do.
Yeah, Jeff. Get back. You're going to have to get a whole lot of Linex ready. So I met with Linex. We had a good meeting. I'm going to go meet with Jeff, go over my ideas, put it on a rendering, shoot it over them. Hopefully they love it and we can start building. So we got Linex, one of our good partners.
Yeah, it coats things for us.
Yeah, so it's like, Linex is known for bed liners, right? Everybody that knows Linex, it's like, yeah, you spray in the inside of your bed. So I talked him into doing a Camaro, but the exterior, I want to Linex the whole thing and add color to it.
Okay. Oh, a colored Linex?
Yes. So now I need you to take that idea and put it on this, and then I can take it to them and say, look. And they can say, cool, build it.
Okay. Are we going to do a lot to the interior too?
I think an interior view would be cool, just so they can comprehend like doing the interior pieces. So we would two-tone the wheels paint usually, but let's two-tone the Linex the wheels. Now let's two-tone the interior. So all that kind of stuff I want to add into the car. You think you can get that done in a couple hours so I can get them to approve it and we can start building it?
It's actually done already.
Really?
I can do Camaros really easy. I've done 1,000 of them. But this one's a little bit different, so it should look pretty cool.
Coming up on West Coast Customs.
You got this Camaro?
Yes, sir.
Let's check it out.
All right.
Wait till you see what we're going to do to this one.
So the rendering's done. It's been approved. The next step is to find a car. So I called up the local dealership that we always deal with, Connell Chevrolet, and said we need a black Camaro. They have one on the lot. They said come grab it. I invited Linex over to do a build for us. I wanted to Linex our big rig. It turned into them wanting us to do a build for them. We found a local dealership that had a black-on-black Camaro. We brought it in. We called up our friends from SLP. They brought in all their top-of-line product for it, from brakes to headers to suspension. And then the next step was to get Linex. So they came in, Linex the whole car black. Then we did some blue racing stripes on it. We also did the wheels, the speaker box, and some interior pieces. Then it was time for Ish to do his magic on the seats and the door panels. Then it was time to get supercharged. Now we're in the final assembly stage. After that, we have to get this car on the road and get it off the Linex for the big reveal.
Now it's time to hear this beast. That smell of four is perfect.
Now the Camaro, it looks amazing. I mean, this body armor, I think, is going to be something totally different for them as a brand. And to see color on top of their black traditional Line X, I think it's going to blow people away. So the Camaro's done, turned out amazing. I think, you know, the SLP performance that they added to it makes a huge difference. So I'm gonna go test drive it, make sure everything's cool, and then we'll get it off the Line X. Big rig just got here, it's about to pull up. I'm gonna go inside, get their team, bring them out here. We're gonna look at the big rig. I'm gonna open the door, and then I'm gonna pull out their surprise.
Hey Ryan, what's going on?
Good to see you.
Looks good. Let me introduce you to Kevin.
Here's the key. It's a Camaro for our friends at Line X. But since we've done so many Camaros, it should be pretty easy.
Right? Nothing's easy.
Nothing's easy. But the good news is we don't have to paint it, because they're going to Line X the whole thing. So they'll come in here. I figure that's why we start in here.
Okay.
So they can set up in here and do their Line X-ing. We can do the interior and then head to toe Line X. Interior pieces, wheels. But this will be unique. I mean, since we've been Line X-ing everything from
big rig
our big rig down to our van to Jeeps to whatever, we might as well do this for them.
I know.
So get SLP on the phone. Get everything they got for this thing. I say we leave it in here, the whole build.
Yeah, we'll tear it down right in here.
Yeah, tear it down in here, let Line X come in, do what they need to do, and then you can get Ish on the interior and, you know, get Alex pulling the stereo system.
I think we strip it, get all lift too, and get everything inside of it too, body braces, everything, and then get back in here for the Line X.
Okay, yeah, however you want to do it. The plan's the plan. Keep your hands, buddy.
Like always.
Yeah, knock it out. All right, I'll get on the phone with SLP.
All righty.
I just went over the build with Kenny. He's gonna get a team in here right now. They're gonna break it down. Tomorrow we're gonna put it over to lift. Hopefully SLP will have us all of our stuff by tomorrow. We're gonna Line X a lot of these interior pieces to really give it a blue accent. The cool thing about this is we're gonna show Line X being used in different ways than what people know Line X as.
It's a whole different process than just painting a car. We're actually gonna have a really efficient texture to it. Two-tone it, change the whole interior up, kind of give it something different that we've always done at West Coast. We got SLP involved, we put supercharger, brakes, suspension, body braces, suspension coils and everything. Basically, package everything under this car, so we got the speed with the texture. First thing you do, grab my guys and get it torn down.
To showcase the new Line X body armor, it's time to put away the bed liners and bring in some muscle. GM will provide us with a 2013 Camaro, the perfect platform to put Line X to the test. The first thing to do is to tear this car down. We're gonna remove the old exhaust, put on a new SLP exhaust, headers, and suspension. A new body kit will complete the design. Next, it's time to Line X the car from head to toe. We'll base the entire car in black and then lay out some blue stripes for a bold new look. Moving inside, blue Line X doors will echo the blue accents on the dash. And seats in black leather and suede with blue diamond stitching. An SLP supercharger will add a burst of horsepower to make this a true muscle car. And every car needs a great sound system. So we're gonna beef up the factory stereo using MB Quartz amps and subs, sitting in a custom Line X enclosure. And to finish it off, Continental tires will ride on Line X Asante wheels and Oracle headlights will light the way. It's time to move beyond truck beds and bring Line X into the future. Next on West Coast Customs. Before Line X can come here and shoot this Camaro, they have to.
But the stitch is going to come through here. Believe me this, my friend. It's going to look very nice.
Ryan going to like it?
You only have one choice. Like it or like it.
All right.
We actually have to raise the weight every single line by hand and then slowly peel up the paper. Now, since I get the paper off, the next thing I do is kind of recreate the lines I actually taped on there. I'm gonna lay all my tape back out and actually raise the blade between each and every one. And here goes nothing.
Coming up on West Coast Customs.
In the shop, there's always guys, and we're always doing what we do. So to bring a girl in and show these guys how to do it, it's going to be interesting.
The superchargers take 9 to 12 hours to install.
This one, I'm going to have done in about 4 hours.
So we've already installed the SLP headers and exhaust system, but to really give this car some boost, we're going to add a supercharger. So the SLP guys are going to send their techs out to install one.
What's up, Dave?
Hey, Ryan, how you doing?
Good, sir.
Good
thank
to see
you for coming out.
Oh, thank you.
Hi.
Ryan, this is Jessica.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
This is Brian.
Hey, Brian.
How you
nice
doing,
to
man?
Meet you.
Jessica's going to be doing the install today.
Oh, cool. It's nice to have a girl in the shop.
Absolutely.
Be good. Do you need anything else from us?
No, I think we've got tools, coffee, I think we're good to go.
Tools and coffee will be good to go, huh?
That's all we need.
All right. When do you think you'll be done with it?
Should take about 3.5-4 hours.
Wow.
Think so.
Today we're going to be installing a brand new SLP supercharger. This is the first of an SLP line of superchargers, and this happens to be our very first production piece that we're installing on a Camaro. Typically, superchargers take anywhere from 9 to 12 hours to install.
The great thing about the supercharger is it's been completely redesigned. This one I'm going to have done in about 4 hours or so. It is also going to add 160 rear wheel horsepower to the car versus the older generation only adding 120. It's going to be really fast.
So I just met with David and his team from SLP. He brought Jessica with him, an installer, which is cool, you know. In the shop, there's always guys, and we're always doing what we do. So to bring a girl and show these guys how to do it, it's going to be interesting. She said she'll be done in 4 hours. Hopefully she gets it done a little bit sooner. We can go do some donuts.
And now we're ready to install a supercharger. This is the component that forces the air into the engine, and more air equals more horsepower.